So one of the things I love to do is work with Unity. And wouldn't it be nice if you could just take a 3D model out of Unity and use it as an apple? Unfortunately, it's not as simple and straightforward because Apple only, for some strange reason, works with USDZ file format. So all the traditional 3D file formats like FBX and OBJ, you can't use with AR frameworks in Apple like Reality Composer. Instead, you need to convert it somehow to a USDZ file. So to take a model from Unity and use it all the way in an Apple system, you need to do three things. First, find a model in Unity, either to the asset store or your own prefabs. And from there, you can convert that prefab into an FBX file using a tool I'll show you soon. And then once you have the FBX file, you can convert that to a USDZ file using an Apple's software called Reality Converter. So Unity to FBX to Reality Converter. That's what we'll do. So let's get started and I'll show how to do this exactly. So now we're in Unity and here we have a 3D model which I downloaded from the asset store. You could get your own. And this, if I play it, you can see also has an animation. So now what I want to do is take this model along with its animation and convert it into a FBX file format. So FBX is a commonly used 3D file format, and that's what I'm trying to do here first. So to convert a Unity prefab into an FBX format, there's a nice package called FBX Exposure within Unity. And if you don't have that, you could go to Windows and go to Package Manager, and you could type in FBX Exposure to find it. And here I have it already, but if you still can't find it, you could also go to Advanced and click on that option. It may take a while to load. And then just make sure that Show Preview Packages is selected because FBX Exposure is in preview mode. And once you have that, you can install it. And once it's installed, then you can go to your prefab in Unity, which you want to convert. So this is the prefab corresponding to the Dragon. And then I'm just gonna right click and then choose Export to FBX. Once I click that, just make sure that you include both the models and the animation because we want both. And I'm just gonna select my desktop as the destination. So now if I click Export, yeah, this is because I already have one file with the same name. I'm just gonna override it. Now if I look at my desktop, you can see that the FBX file is ready. So that's step one. Step two is now we want to convert this FBX 3D file format into a USDZ file format. So Apple only works with USDZ file formats and not the other ones, and that's why we need to do this conversion. For that, there's a really handy tool called Reality Converter, again provided by Apple. So I'm going to open that, and it's very simple to use. All I have to do is take my FBX file and just drop it in here, and it will automatically convert it to a USD format. So now it's imported, and if I drag around, you can see it's working fine. If I click play, you could also see the animation. So that's working fine. So next, what I want to do is take this model and export it to USD format and save it in my desktop. So I'm gonna export it and choose desktop as my location. Now I'm just going to open up a Reality Composer project and just make sure it's working. So now if you look here, it's my 3D model, the USDZ format, and I'm just gonna drag it onto the scene. Definitely, it looks way too big now, so I'm just going to click on it, Inspector, and then just scale it down. That looks great. Now if I play it, you notice there's no animation, and that's because we haven't added any behaviors yet. So I'm going to go to Behavior, add in just a behavior called animation. And then I'm just gonna trigger this at the start of the scene. And as the action, what I want to do is play the animation that came bundled with the USDZ file. So I'm gonna click USDZ animation and choose the dragon as the affected object. And now if I click play, you should see that the animation's working.
So that's how you take a 3D model out of Unity and use it in Apple. Hope you found that useful, and for more AR tutorials for the Apple ecosystem, do subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you next week.